What is your position on the Federal Reserve? Should it indeed be audited and be held accountable by the American people?
Senator Santorum.
I agree with an audit of the Federal Reserve. I believe that what we should do with the Fed is to make it a single charter instead of a dual charter. I think the second charter that was instituted that had it be responsible for increasing employment and dealing with that leads to a fundamental distrust among the American people that they are taking their eye off the ball, which is sound money. Sound money.
How would you handle the trade debt?
We wouldn't worry a whole lot about it. We'd have sound money. And when you have sound money and free trade, you don't worry about trade deficits. Do you know what the trade deficit is between New York and Texas? Nobody knows and nobody cares. If we don't have enough money in Texas, we have to quit buying. That's what would happen in the world if you had a sound monetary system, a gold standard where people couldn't create money out of thin air. The only time these trade deficits mean something is when you're on an inflated paper money system like we are today, and then they mean something. So if you have a gold standard, sound money, and free markets, you don't even keep the records. If you spend too much money and you come up short, you got to go back to work and earn some money before you can buy things from Japan.
It's too much welfare. We cut back on welfare. It's too much interest on the national debt. A sound currency would lower the interest payment. So we would balance the budget and media at a much lower level. I think it would be the greatest thing in the world for the economy.
What should government do?
Protect our freedoms. Have a strong national defense. Look and take care of our borders. Have a sound currency. So we want to have a protection of the general welfare, the general environment of free markets and ability to trade with each other and travel among the states. That was the responsibility of the federal government, not to run our lives and run everything in the economy and extend, you know, the Interstate Commerce Clause and the General Welfare Clause to do anything they want to do. That is what has happened.
We need the government out of the way, but it should have sound money, low taxes, less regulations, and a sensible policy where we're not wasting our money overseas.
What you have to do is restore sound money. You have to understand why you have a business cycle, why you have booms and busts. If you don't do that, there's no way you can solve these problems. And the booms and busts comes from a failed monetary system. The interest rates that are way lower than they should be encourages malinvestment and debt. And to get out of that, all this other tinkering, you cannot do that unless you liquidate debt. You don't bail out the people that are bankrupt and dump the debt on the people. The president's not supposed to manage and run the economy. The people are supposed to do this. The government's supposed to give them sound money, low taxes, less regulations. The people are supposed to run it. But here we're assuming that the president's supposed to run the economy.
They don't have a right to a house or a right to a job or a right to medical care. And besides, once government decides those are rights, you end up with much less. Once the government gets involved in planning, central planning, whether it's education or medicine or housing, look at what they did when they decided everybody should have a house. We had a housing bubble. Now we have a housing bubble that's collapsing. People are losing their homes. So this whole motivation, the purpose of government is to protect liberty and understand how the marketplace works. So a truly compassionate person would argue the case for truly free markets and sound money. money. That's what we need. Then you would help people.
I do think that we pushed some of these programs with community reinvestment acts and easy credit. There were a lot of things that encouraged this. Where I'm convinced that if we had a little sounder monetary system and we didn't have this so easy credit, people wouldn't be making so many mistakes.
History is on the side of hard money. If you look at stable prices, you have to look to the only historic sound money that's lasted more than a few years. Fiat money always in.
The way we get into this trouble is due to accepting some notions about money that are false. We have believed since 1971 that there should be no linkage of our money to anything sound as the Constitution mandates. There should be no linkage of the dollar to gold or silver, which then gives the Congress the leeway of spending endlessly. Deficits don't matter. We can tax and we can borrow, but if we still don't have enough money, we can depend on the Federal Reserve just to print the money.
Next book came out this week, End the Fed, and we're having a lot of excitement surrounding this. And I've had a lot of interviews on this. Today, somebody asked me, what should I do in this country to improve our economy? My answer was very simple, End the Fed. The Fed is the culprit, and I talk about that in this book and explain why the Fed not only creates our problems, they perpetuate the problems, and the sooner we come around to understanding that, and at first, of course, get the audit of the Fed, but eventually, we have to end the Fed if we care about sound money, personal liberties, limited government. This is the book that you have to read.
So we need to get busy and really have change because we need to immediately balance the budget, pay down some of the debt, let people go back to work, bring our troops home, have sound money. That's a revolution.
If you want change, what you need is somebody that's going to make sure you're never going to have a draft and that we're going to bring our troops home, we're going to balance the budget, we're going to have sound money. He never talks about any of that.
The role for the government ought to be giving us a sound currency, not a bunch or a few people in secret rooms that have monopoly control over the money supply and the interest rates. That's not in the Constitution.
People who like individual liberties and free markets and sound money.
My proposal is to legalize competition with the Fed, and that is for you to have the constitutional right to use sound money, gold and silver currency. If you do that today, you'll be arrested. Even though you would be on them, you'd be correct constitutionally, they will put you in jail for that. So my idea is to legalize that, get rid of the legal tender laws, and people who like the Fed like paper money, fine. If others like to deal in silver coin currency or gold currency, they should be allowed to do it.
You also don't believe that medical care is a right. Now, as a gynecologist, you're a doctor. How do you justify that sort of feeling like not every American deserves the right to good medical care?
You don't have a right to things and services. You have a right to your life. You have a right to your liberty.
Yeah.
And if you want good medical care or if you want a healthy economy, you have to have a free market economy with sound money and good contract laws, and then there'll be great prosperity. But we have a system of corporatism now where business and governments are partners, and they rip us off. I think it's much better to bite the bullet and say we've lived beyond our means, we ought to live within our means, we ought to have a sound currency and balanced budget. We need to have a system where we invite capital back into this country. We destroy the incentive to bring capital here. I mean, if you have a company and you have a lot of money overseas, you get taxed to bring it back.
You know, the biggest thing, though, long-term that we could do for Haiti would be to introduce them to sound economic policies so that they wouldn't suffer. I mean, their buildings were built poorly and the people are so poor. And just handing out money is not going to solve that problem. They need to be introduced to the philosophy of free markets and sound money so they can be more prosperous, build better houses.
Who would have ever dreamed a few years ago that our monetary system would get the attention? I consider that very, very important. But now the young people on the campuses are studying Austrian economics and sound money, and they know about how silly paper money is and why that gives us booms and busts and unemployment. So I think that's exciting.
You know, it's really scary to see what can happen in a society when the overspending comes home to roost, you know, when you see the consequences of years and years of overspending. Obviously, people here are very worried about our debt and our deficit. Congressman Paul, could this kind of thing happen here? Could what we're seeing in Greece and California happen on a nationwide basis here?
Absolutely, and there's going to be anger and there's going to be riots in the streets as well. But this is all a consequence of the fact that why and how do governments spend like this? It's because they don't have sound money. When we run up deficits, we tax, but never enough. We can't tax, it would ruin the economy. Then we borrow and we get away with that for a long time. But we rely on the printing presses from the Federal Reserve to create the money. And that's where the problem is.
Size up the Republican race for me a little bit. What do you think of Sarah Palin?
No, I'm not much into sizing up anybody. Well, I can size them up as a group. I think so far most of them represent the status quo, you know, and not any. I think they're shifting a little bit because of the political pressure. But who's saying bring all the troops home? Who's saying that we need sound money and we ought to believe in the Constitution? Who wants to get rid of the Patriot Act? Who believes in property rights? You know, they're going to modify their position, but they represent the status quo. And this is what excites so many people. Now they're sick of the status quo.
Will there be a deal to raise the debt ceiling this month?
Well, I don't think anybody has an absolute answer to that, but I have my suspicions, and I would bet on that there will be.
And much to your unhappiness.
Sure. I mean, I came into the Congress a good many years ago, and my goal was to shrink the size of government and balance our budget, pay the bills, have sound money, and live within our means and mind our own business. And I haven't done a very good job. It seems like we're going in the wrong direction.
Currency is sound only when it is recognized and accepted as such by individuals through the actions of the market without coercion. Throughout history, gold and silver have been the two commodities that have most fully satisfied the requirements of sound money.
You are a disciple of what's called the Austrian School of Economics. What is that, briefly? And what would economists like Ludwig von Mises and Friedrich Hayek, who were two of the leaders of the Austrian School of Economics, what would they say is the right way to deal with boosting the economy now and with dealing with our national debt?
Well, they asked Mises that one time. They were having runaway inflation in Austria. It's Austrian economics because the main leaders of the school came. They escaped. They were mostly Jewish, and they came over here to escape Nazism. And they asked him once at the height of a crisis like this, and there was a bit more inflation, and they said to Mises, what would you do? And he said, I'd resign. In other words, take your hands off of it. Let the people take care of it. Let the people who have lived beyond their means, let them go bankrupt. Let the liquidation occur. Get rid of the malinvestment like we did in 1921. We recovered, it's not even hardly in our textbook, about the Depression of 1921, which was a natural consequence of the inflation for World War I. So we want our hands off. The Depression lasted 17 years because we wouldn't do that. Japan has had hands-on. They've been in the doldrums for 20 years. And we're now into this one. It's a lot more than 5 years. We're basically been in over 10 years that our economy has been slipping. So they would say, hands off, give us a sound currency, free up the markets, property rights, enforce contracts, make sure people go bankrupt when they're bankrupt, and don't bail out their buddies. Don't let the Federal Reserve create money out of thin air.
The philosophy of this country is shifting. It is shifting in the direction of the Constitution, limited government, a foreign policy that is different, balancing our budget, having sound money. So I would say it's coming together. The philosophy is coming together with a political change. And we've talked about this even 4 years ago. It was coined as a revolution.
They should be a sound money Federal Reserve. That should be their single charter, and that is it. With respect to some of the questions that were asked in the last segment on the economy, I would just say this. Some people say that Barack Obama's economy is a disaster. My feeling is it would have to make a dramatic improvement just to be a disaster. What we need to do is have a pro-growth plan that can pass the Congress with Democratic support, and as Newt mentioned, be able to rally the American people. What the American people want is a policy that's going to get people the opportunity to rise in society, to fill that great middle of America, and that is manufacturing jobs. That's why my plan takes the corporate tax, which is 35%, cuts it to zero, and says, if you manufacture in America, you aren't going to pay any taxes. We want you to come back here. We want you to have Made in America stamped on your plan.
Mr. Kane.
Yes.
You were once with the Kansas City Federal Reserve. Should it be audited?
Yes, it can. It should be audited. And secondly, I believe that its focus needs to be narrowed. I don't believe in the Fed. I believe in fixing the Fed. For many, many decades, the Fed did its job when it was singularly focused on sound money. When we wake up in the morning, we expect 60 minutes to be in an hour. Now, when we wake up because of some of the actions of the current Fed, we don't know what the value of the dollar is going to be. In 1988, it took $1.2 in order to be able to convert from Canadian to U.S. It is now totally reversed because of the current policies of the Fed.
Thank you. Congresswoman Bachman, you know that Governor Perry has suggested that Ben Bernanke, the head of the Federal Reserve, potentially should be tried for treason for what he's doing. Do you agree?
Well, as President of the United States, I would not be reappointing Ben Bernanke, but I want to say this. During the bailout, the $700 billion bailout, I worked behind the scenes against the bailout because one thing that I saw from the Federal Reserve, the Enabling Act legislation is written so broadly that quite literally, Congress has given the Federal Reserve almost unlimited power over the economy. That has to change. They can no longer have that power. Why? Because what we saw with all of the $700 billion bailout is that the Federal Reserve opened its discount window and was making loans to private American businesses. And not only that, they were making loans to foreign governments. This cannot be. The Federal Reserve has a lot to answer for, and that's why it's important that they're not only audited, but they have got to be shrunk back down to such a tight leash that they're going to squeak.
It's one thing to say you wouldn't reappoint him, Ben Bernanke, to be head of the Federal Reserve. It's another thing. Do you agree or disagree with Governor Perry that potentially he's engaged in treason?
Well, that's for Governor Perry to make that decision. My opinion is I would not reappoint Ben Bernanke.
You stand by those remarks, Governor?
I said that if you are allowing the Federal Reserve to be used for political purposes, that it would be almost treasonous. I think that is a very clear statement of fact. I am not a fan of the current chairman allowing that Federal Reserve to be used to cover up bad fiscal policy by this administration, and that, I will suggest to you, is what we have seen. It is a travesty that young people in America are seeing their dollars devalued in what we don't know if it was political or not because of the transparency issue. But I stand by this, that we need to have a Fed that is working towards sound monetary policy that creates a strong dollar in America, and we do not have that today.
Governor Romney, is there anything you disagree with Governor Perry on that point?
Well, my own view is that, quite simply, that the Federal Reserve has a responsibility to preserve the value of our currency, to have a strong American currency such that investors and people who are thinking about bringing enterprises to this country have confidence in the future of America and in our currency. People will not invest in this country and create jobs in this country for the American people if they don't have belief in our currency. Of course, we should see what the Fed is doing. There should be some oversight to make sure that it's acting properly. But at the same time, we recognize that we need to have a Fed. Why do I say that? Because if we don't have a Fed, who's going to run the currency? Congress? I'm not in favor of that. I'd rather have an agency that is being overseen rather than have the United States Congress try and manage our currency.
All right, let's take another question from the hall. Go ahead, and please identify yourself.
They come from a dying world. They drift through the universe, pushed on by the solar winds. They adapt, and they survive. The function of all life is survival.
Sleep. Sleep. Sleep.
From deep space,
sleep.
The seed is planted.
Sleep. Sleep.
Terror grows.
Matthew! Matthew! Matthew!
It's got no detail, no character. It's unformed.
All of a sudden, they're growing like parasites. Is it contagious? People are being duplicated.
How do you know my name? I didn't tell you my name.
I can't find anything in here that looks like a body.
My side's nosebleed.
It looked right at me.
You're looking at it as if it was human. It was not human.
Now, the classic fear begins to grow.
We're being cornered.
You can win around the country.
There's a revolution going on, Chris.
Are you the leader?
Glad you're checking up on us.
Are you the leader?